Can you improve your intelligence by putting on the right clothes? In 2012, a fascinating piece of research was published by Adam and Galinsky, in which they showed that when participants wore a doctor's coat, their cognitive abilities seemed to improve. But what most people don't know, and I mean this piece of research really got a lot of media attention, what most people don't know is that one of their experiments actually could not be replicated. But first, let's take a short look at what they actually did in their experiments. In the first experiment, they had 58 participants. I wish they would have had more, who were divided into two groups, and their cover story to make them wear these lab coats was to say, well, we are conducting this experiment for a while now, and when we began the experiment, the laboratory was under construction. So the participants in the first run had to wear coats. So it is essential that you wear these lab coats as well to have similar conditions. And while wearing these lab coats, the participants had to take part in the classical Stroop test. Some of you probably already know this test. It's a test in which you are presented with color words, like for example the word blue, but the letters of the word have a different color. So for example, the color yellow. And your task is not to read the name of the word, so you don't say blue, but you have to resist to say blue and instead to say yellow, because you only have to name the color of the letters. So this is a classical inhibition task in which you have to suppress your first impulse and to concentrate your attention onto something else. And the results of this study really seemed fascinating, because in this classical cognitive test, those participants who wore the lab coat actually conducted less errors. And the idea of enclosed cognition, that what you're wearing is influencing your cognition, seems to be supported in experiment 2 and 3. In those experiments, in which they luckily had some more participants, in experiment 2 they had 74 and in experiment 3 they had 99 participants. In those experiments, the approach actually was even a little bit more clever, because they made participants wear the same coats, but one time they told them, well, it's a doctor's coat, but in another condition they told them, well, it's the coat of a painter. So now you have two different primings. The first one is the doctor priming, which is associated with being intelligent, having high attention. And on the other hand, you have the painter, which is more associated with being creative and maybe a little bit chaotic. And indeed, again, in this experiment, they could show, this time with different cognitive tests. I guess you know this kind of cognitive test as well. You were shown two pictures, for example, of a nice building, and the two pictures seem to be identical, but there are some small differences and you have to spot the differences. So a really classic. And when they analyzed the data again in these two experiments, those who were wearing the doctor's coat outperformed those who had thought they are wearing a painter's coat. So at first sight, really fantastic results. But as I said, the problem is that one of those experiments, the first one, actually in a new study published 7 years later, published in 2019, could not replicate the results. Even though they did almost everything exactly the same way, and even though they had more participants, so more statistical power, all in all they had 400 participants, whereas in the original study they only had, as I said, 58 participants, they were not able to show that wearing a doctor's coat actually improved the performance in the Stroop test. So what is going on? Well, there are some explanations. First of all, it might have been that the original authors, Adam and Galinsky, they might have conducted several small experiments. And if you do so, if you conduct a lot of small experiments, chances are quite high that you get one false positive result. And if you only publish this one positive result and ignore all the non-significant results, then of course this is highly problematic. Another explanation might be that they actually conducted not only the Stroop test, but maybe they conducted a lot of other cognitive tests. And I mean, if I had conducted this experiment, I probably would have conducted tests of general intelligence as well, like for example the Raven matrices. And maybe, and I know this is pure speculation, but maybe this is exactly what they did. They conducted several cognitive tests and they only published the one which was positive and which actually then might have been a false positive. But aside from some kind of scientific misconduct, there might also be another plausible explanation, because it could also be that maybe the participants who took part in this replication study actually did not have such a strong association between scientists and doctors and being intelligent or having strong attention. Because, as I said, the study was published in 2019 in the United States at a time Donald Trump was president, and in which the belief in science and medicine was actually not that strong. So maybe this could have affected the results as well. But surely there will have to be more research to answer those questions. So what's the conclusion? Is enclosed cognition a hoax? Does it not work at all? Does what you are wearing not influence your thinking or your behavior? Fortunately, there are some more studies to answer this question. So, for example, take a look at the study by Lopez and colleagues, in which they could show that when participants were told that a tunic that they had to wear for the experiment either was the tunic of a nurse or the tunic of a cleaner. And when they thought that they are wearing the tunic of a nurse, the participants showed more empathy and they were more willing to help somebody in need of help. In another study, it could be shown that participants who were wearing a business suit in comparison to participants who had to wear sweatpants negotiated much more assertive, and they also had higher levels of testosterone. So they really behaved like business alpha males. And maybe the most scary results come from classical de-individuation experiments in which nurses had to wear Ku Klux Klan-like coats and gave electric shocks to an alleged victim that were 2 times longer than in the control condition. So from a psychological point of view, there is absolutely no doubt that what we are wearing can affect our behavior. And I mean, unfortunately, we see that in every war, when people are wearing uniforms, they also lose their scruples. There is no doubt that what we are wearing can affect our behavior. But at this point in time, I would not bet that you can also improve your intelligence just by wearing something else. Maybe you can have a little bit more sustained attention, but when it comes to higher cognitive processes, probably the effects are too weak. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you want, take a look at the books or take a look at the website. Or if you found this episode helpful, feel free to give a thumbs up. And maybe we will see you next time.